3D all this polygon, and then the polygon is also looking shaped into your polygon that you already pre-created using the Google Earth. It's already being imported into your QGIS, and then you want to merge it, okay, to make it more beautiful. Perhaps I want to adjust a little bit this one, okay, I adjust this one so that it's much more closer and much more accurate. Okay, but you can zoom in to make sure that the line perfect. Okay, so it depends on how accurate is your study. It can be up to kilometer levels or meter levels, so depends on your field. So in our field, in fact, we just want to have the clear idea of the spatial location of this particular data set. Okay, you can just smoothing it around. Okay, you can zoom it more and so on. Oh, it's kind of weird a little bit, never mind. So I'm going to sieve it, and then I'm going to combine it, all of these 11, right? You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You got 12 sub-district. So you want to combine all of these sub-district. Oh, okay, this one also I observe some anomalies. So perhaps I want to adjust this one also can. I'm just going to adjust it to make it more realistic, so that our map, I'm not going to draw at the river level. So don't forget to save. Okay, so far so good. Okay, so far so good. It's acceptable. Alright, so now you want to combine it, right? So how to combine? Oh, I'm so sorry. So how to combine? You can go to this vector data management, merge vector layers. So we're going to select our mukim 1, mukim 2 until mukim 11, for example, and then you're going to hit OK. In my matching test, if I click OK, it's actually at the back. So destination coordinate system will be WGS 84. And then merge into the new component, so we can just run it. So after you run it, so this merge map are going to be displayed for you. So in fact, you also want to change this transparency also can. So now you create the whole map. You see, this one is the ID, so you can name it. You can make changes of it and so on. Right, and then the most important thing is you can save it. Okay, you can export, save features as. So this one you can save it as not Mukim, but actually it's a Mua map. Mua district. Okay. And then you can just hit OK. This one you can remove. Alright, so your Mua district is already being spelled out, and you can adjust accordingly this this thing. Perhaps usually I'm going to delete whatever that is not true. Okay, the path also probably not the important things to have it, and then don't forget to save. So now you have the map that is already being created using the Google Earth and also QGIS for the purpose of the mapping. So after this, we can plot this polygon and then put some input or put some attributes so that we can further analyze in our geospatial analysis. So hope you can got some benefit from this video and try to do it yourself. Bye bye.